My son's name is Caleb. He's a little over 3 years old. He was diagnosed with cerebral palsy when he was around 6 to 7 months of age. Since the last time we spoke, I had just taken the What to Do About Your Brain Injured Child course. About a week later, we flew to Pennsylvania. My husband, myself, and my son. We spent a week here learning all about the program. And since that time, since we arrived back home, we started the intensive treatment program and the changes we have seen. Before that, we were just starting on the belly, moving the arms and legs some, short amount of distance. Now he's actually crawling in the proper crawling pattern around 300 feet a day, which is, you know, I remember the day we were happy he rolled or he barely moved. And that was, you know, that was even after just reading the book last summer. And now he's 300 feet in a day. Also, he can probably say at least 10 couplets to sounds, you know, I do, I am, things like that. His language has improved drastically when he wasn't really hardly making any, you couldn't understand a lot of things. I don't even know really where to start. He can read. I mean, he can read anything that you give him. We pick out a dictionary now. Anything you ask, he loves Play and Find It because he can show you that he can read. We've done the reading program, and he's probably seen over 1,500 words, 800 to 1,000 sentences, 50-something of his homemade books, every single thing he can read. I haven't found a word. The only word he got wrong, his sister is in college, and I said to her, pick out three of your hardest words in your doctorate program. And we put them on the board. I put him on the communication board, and he played fine. Did he chose the right one? The only one he got wrong was because I misspelled it. And we removed them, spelled that word right, mixed them up. There's nothing he's not been able to do. It's just phenomenal. I could go on and on at how much he's improved. To me, as his mother that's with him 24 hours a day, the best thing that's happened to Caleb since we started is his ability to communicate. His awareness, the fact that prior to being here on this campus and realizing my son's potential, you know, you could have just looked at him and just thought, oh, he's in another world, or I don't, you know, he doesn't know this, and it's not true. He can tell me anything in the world he wants, and because I believe he can do it. You've all shown me how to do it and giving him that opportunity. Probably for me is communication and mobility is enormous, but the awareness with the respiratory programs that he's on, really everywhere from head to toe, even nutrition, sleeping all night, he's just a different child. A last thing that really stands out is I remember when, before we really changed our nutrition and all the things that you all had recommended that we do, we were, every week pretty much, we were down because of respiratory illnesses or some type of infection. At least once a year when the winter hit, we were in the emergency room, breathing treatments constantly. In over a year, he was sick one day, and that was just a slight temp. Nothing that put him down, didn't require any antibiotics, one day in a year. So. Just in Caleb himself, I've seen an enormous amount of changes. For one, with his behavior, we could, for example, when I tell Caleb, Caleb, you want to go to town? And I'm excited, I'm going to go take him, we're going to have a reward, a day out. Before, just upset, just whining, fussing, irritable. But now, through the auditory program we've been given and the communication, he's been able to tell me that The reason he didn't want to go this whole time is because of the noise and the environment. And as long as I take his earplugs or his cancellation headphones, then he's happy to go. And usually anywhere we go, if he's upset, the behavior this whole time, I truly believe now it was attributed to the environment in itself or his inability to communicate with me. And because of those two problems now being taken care of, I mean, he's happy. He's happy. And if he's fussy at all now, all I tell him is, Caleb, just calm down for 1 minute. You want mommy to get your board? Yeah. I get his board and he smiles because he knows we're going to figure it out. Before, there was no way. So we have no behavior issues now. It's great. So you're wanting to know, is the program really worth the amount of effort, time, energy, your marriage, everything? There's been many times, at least a couple of days a week, it's the intensity of it. I ask myself that at night when I have a few minutes to myself. And there's no question. I mean, it's not about me. It's about my son. And I've asked God over and over, God, you know, change this if this is not what you want me to be. And he just says, keep on. Just keep on doing what you're doing. I'm going to give you the strength that you need. And then I take a deep breath and we go in it. We just do it again the next day. And, you know, there's a lot of days that are really, really tough. And sometimes those, you know, it requires all of mommy. But it's worth it. I mean, this is my son and his life. His life is at stake. I'm fighting for my son's life. And so I just think of it that way. And my husband does too. And we both have the same vision. And that's ultimately to do whatever it takes for our son to reach his maximum potential. And at the end of the day, it's always worth it. We already know the sacrifices that we've had to make in our marriage. And when we look at our son and we see the things he's doing, then we both say that it's worth it. This is the second trip that we've made here to the Institute. I have to say honestly that my husband and I thought, you know, that's a lot of time away from your work and the travel. We've traveled over 1,000 miles to be here, and it has been worth it. We've learned so much. The lectures have helped us to really understand more about his intelligence, how to, you know, when you have a child that's learning and reading at his level so quickly, you want to know, how in the world do I keep up with him? And they really put you on that path to do that. And they always have something right on the next corner, you know, to keep you moving in the right direction. The mobility, we were able to see, you know, yes, our son is getting more distance in the day, but how can he go from crawling to creeping? And he's right on the verge of it. And the things that we're learning to help him with the balance and all he needs to go that level, we could not, you know, I could call you all back and forth, but it's nothing like being here hands-on and really seeing, and you seeing for yourself what my son's doing to take him to the next level. The communication, we were only using the choice board, and they saw the potential. You all saw that our son could communicate. So now, just since yesterday and today, we've used the facilitated communication, and he has spelled out probably at least 10 things now. And I'm thinking, I had no idea. I mean, just a real quick example, he's never used that in his life, never spelled anything in his life on his own. But we were sitting in the office yesterday of one of you, and going over his intelligence, and she showed him a level, that was a chemistry. This was actually a book. It had something about writing and Hebrew language. I don't really know. I didn't see the pages that quick. She opened it. He had 2 seconds to look at these two. It looked like a college textbook, and she used that facilitated communication board and asked Caleb, was it about Babylonia or Egypt? And he spelled Babylonia. And I felt the color drop out of my face. And I mean, you know, this sounds like a fairy tale and like it's too good to be true, but we are walking this out day by day. And I mean, this is the second trip is absolutely necessary. I mean, you have to keep progressing. We don't ever want to stay the same. We want to get him all the way till he can't go anymore. But the next one we're really looking for is that level of crawling to creeping. So that's what we're going to go home and we're going to hit that hard. And I hope the next time we come back, we're up on our hands and knees.
That's great. Thank you so much. Thank you. I really appreciate it.